Represent the following data using a box and whiskers plot. Exclude the median when computing the quartiles. All right, let's see if we can do this. So we have a bunch of data here, and they say if it helps, you might drag the numbers to put them in a different order, so we can drag these numbers around, which is useful because we will want to order them. The order isn't checked with your answer. And I'm doing this off of the Khan Academy exercises, so I don't have my drawing tablet here. I just have my mouse, and I'm interacting with the exercise, which I encourage you to do too, because the best way to learn any of this stuff is to actually practice it. And at Khan Academy, we have 150,000 exercises for you to practice with. Anyway, so let's do this. Let's order this thing so we can figure out the range of numbers. What's the lowest and what's the highest? So let's see, there's a 7 here. And then let's see, we have some 8s. We've got some 8s going on. And then we have some 9s. Actually, we have a bunch of 9s. We have 4 9s here. We have some 9s. And then let's see, 13 is the largest number. There we go. We've ordered the numbers. So our smallest number is 7. And this is what the whiskers are useful for helping us figure out the entire range of numbers. Our smallest number is 7. Our largest number is 13. So we know the range. Now let's plot the median. And this will help us, once getting this center line of our box, but then also we need to do that to figure out what these other lines are that kind of define the box, to define the middle 2/4 of our number, of our data, or the middle 2 quartiles, roughly the middle 2 quartiles. It depends how some of the numbers work out. But this middle number, this middle line, is going to be the median of our entire data set. Now the median is just the middle number. If we sort them in order, median is just the middle number. We have 11 numbers here, so the middle one is going to have 5 on either side, so it's going to be this 9. If we had 10 numbers here, if we had an even number of numbers, you actually would have had 2 middle numbers, and then to find the median, you would have found the mean of those 2. If that last sentence was confusing, watch the videos on Khan Academy on median, and I go into much more detail on that. But here I have 11 numbers, so my median is going to be the middle one. It has 5 larger, 5 less, it's this 9 right over here. If I had my pen tablet, I would circle it. So it's this 9, that is the median. And now we need to figure out, well, what number is halfway, or let me put it this way, what number is the median of the numbers in this bottom half? And they told us to exclude the median when we compute the quartiles. So this was the median, let's ignore that. So let's look at all the numbers below that. So this 9, 8, 8, 8, and 7, so we have 5 numbers. What's the median of these 5 numbers? Well, the median is the middle number. That is 8. So the beginning of our second quartile is going to be at 8 right over there. And we do the same thing for our third quartile. Remember, this was our median of our entire data set. Let's exclude it. Let's look at the top half of the numbers, so to speak. And there's 5 numbers here in order. So the middle one, the median of this, is 10. So that's going to be the top of our second quartile. And just like that, we're done. We have constructed our box and whisker plot.